Hi, welcome to Learning Monkey. I am Raghu here. In this class, we will discuss about funnel charts. In our previous classes, we have discussed about bar charts, scatter plots, and we use the concepts which we already discussed in our previous classes. Please follow our playlist from the beginning so that you will have a better understanding of the complete Python for data science. The link for the playlist is provided in the description below. Coming to today's class, let's take an example and understand what funnel charts are. Funnel charts are used to identify the progressive reduction of our data. So let's take an example and understand so that we'll have a better understanding. The data set which we are using here is sample store data set. The discussion about sample store data set and how we identify the sum of sales, all those things were covered in our previous classes. Hoping that the user already know what our data set is. We are explaining, we don't concentrate much on data set because we explained so many times in our previous classes. Coming to our example, in our sample store data set, for constructing the funnel charts, we are taking the, this is our sample store data set, and we are considering the subcategory sum of sales. So we are taking we are group buying based on the subcategory, and we are taking the sum of sales. According to the subcategory, we are taking the sales, sum of sales. And we are taking the sorted value. Ascending is equal to 0 means it will place it in the descending order. According to the sales value, it will take the descending order of our sales. So this is how our values got, which we got it. So on this data set, we are going to construct a funnel chart. In order to construct a funnel chart, so for that, on the x-axis, we have to take temp1.index means this sorted order index is taken as in the x-axis, and the sales value is taken in the y-axis. So sales is equal to temp1 of sales dot values is considered. This will be considered as a y-axis. In order to construct the funnel chart construction, is this package is provided in Plotly. So Plotly is a module which we use for construction of different charts. So one of the use is a funnel chart. We consider using Plotly is a funnel chart. In our coming examples, we will use many of the times Plotly package. So px plotly.express as px, this is considered as a shortcut, px.funnel of a temp1. So this data set is considered into our funnel function. Plotly.funnel, px.funnel function is taken as input as a data frame. Which data frame it is considering? Temp1, means the sorted order values is considered in our funnel function. So what it will do is, it will take the first line, it will construct the funnel chart. It will take the second line, construct the funnel chart. It will take the third line and construct the funnel chart. This is how it will be constructed using the funnel function. So that's why we have given the data frame as input. So what's the output which we got, how the funnel chart looks like, why it got the name funnel? So let's take a look at the funnel chart. This is how the funnel chart, progressive reduction of our data. Funnel charts are used to identify the progressive reduction of our data. Phones are giving highest sales. The next sales are chairs. After that, storage. As we are moving down, the number of sales are decreasing. That's why it's got the name funnel. This looks like the shape of funnel. So this is how the funnel looks like. Okay, that's why it's got the name funnel. So as we moving down, the sale value is decreasing. That's why progressive reduction of our data. In this type of situations, funnel charts are helpful. So by looking at this chart, we can identify which one is giving much sales, which one is giving the less sales. So all these things can be observed by looking at the funnel chart. Coming to our next example, we are taking a stacked funnel charts. So in order to construct the stacked funnel charts, we are taking the year. So how to take the year from the date, all those things were discussed in our previous classes. We are taking the year, and from the data, from this data, we have constructed the year. This is the column which we added for our data frame. From this, we are taking 2013 sales and 2012 data sales. So we are considering only 2 years from our data. Totally, we are having 4 year data set, 2011, 2010, 2012 and 2013. We are considering only here, 2012 and 2013. So from this, we are taking the subcategory, and according to the year, we are taking the sales. 2012 according to the year subcategory sales, sum of sales of subcategories. This is what we considered. We are considering it in two data frames, and these two data frames are concatenated along the concatenated. So data frame concat function is used to concatenate two data frames along the axis is equal to 1, means column wise concatenation will be done. So final dot columns is equal to we are making the column names as 2013 sales and 2012 sales. So sum of columns is equal to final of 2013 sales plus final of 2012 sales. Both are taken into consideration, both the sales, 2012 sales and 2013 sales are considered, and we are doing the addition of the two sales. Sum of two sales, final of total is equal to sum columns, final one is equal to final dot sort values of total comma ascending is equal to 0. According to the total value, we have made it as a in descending order. So this is how our final data set looks like. 2013 sales, 2012 sales, and the total 2012 and 2013 is considered as the total one, and this total is taken here. Total value is considered here. According to the total, we have arranged it in a descending order. So based on the total, we will take the first line and construct the funnel chart. We'll take the second line and construct the funnel chart. How it looks like? Let's take a look at this. Using the funnel, px.funnel of, we are taking this final data frame. Data frame is considered final one. So this is how our funnel chart, stacked funnel chart looks like. So chairs. So here we considered the 2013 and 2012 sales. No need to consider this total sale, but for because we are having the data, we have constructed the funnel chart for both the values, all the values 2013 and 2012, and total value. No need to consider that. Usually everyone will do that on 2013 and 2012 sales, means we have to eliminate this column. Total column should be eliminated, and we have to consider the remaining columns. This is how our stacked funnel chart looks like. By this we can understand so total sale, based on the total sale we have constructed the funnel chart. According to your requirement, you have to select the stacks. Hope you understand the concept. If you have any questions regarding the concept, please post your questions in the comment section below. Thanks for watching. If you haven't subscribed to our channel, please subscribe to our channel and press bell icon for the latest updates. Thank you.